The built-in screenshot tool in GNOME is okay, but we definitely need more than just screen capture. Editing screenshots in a full-blown editor like GIMP is an overkill, and that's why we need tools like Printer or Flameshot. I recently came across a new tool called Gradia, and I'm quite impressed with the features and experience it provides. Let's explore this new screenshot annotation tool for Linux in this video. When you open Gradia, it automatically shows the last few images in the screenshots folder with beautiful backgrounds added to them. Then you have the option to either take a new screenshot or open an existing image for basic editing. Basic editing, because this is not a replacement for GIMP or Photoshop. It allows you to annotate your screenshots so that you can highlight important details. You get all the common annotation tools like freeform pen, text box, lines, arrows, rectangles, and circles, highlighter, redact, and numbers. You can move them around with the selection tool. You can choose the color for your annotation as well as their size. You can also add background to your images. I prefer adding a slight transparent border with shadow as it makes the screenshots look good when I embed them into the website of itsforce.com. You can play with padding, corner radius, shadow, and other stuff here. And if you like those Twitter-styled background, use the gradient feature. Once you are done editing your image, you can either save it or copy it to clipboard that can be posted wherever you like. You can also take a new screenshot that will be immediately available for editing in Gradia. Gradia actually opens the GNOME Screenshots tool for this purpose. The option to open existing images and new screenshots are also available from the top menu. Gradia lets you set some basic preferences as well. You can choose the default folder from where the recent images are displayed when you open Gradia. And then you can choose the default file format for saving your edits along with a compression option. You can also choose whether Gradia should ask you to save a file when you close the application or not. It's a little problematic at this time and I shall discuss that in just a minute. There is option to trace the screenshots that were taken from within Gradia. Interesting feature, and I'll show you how I use it in later section of this video. Lastly, there's option to integrate and directly upload the screenshots to Imgur or some other image sharing websites. It helps in cases where you cannot directly share images, like Reddit replies. Gradia also helps you set custom keyboard shortcuts if you love it too much and want to use it as your main screenshot tool. I tried it and found that the full screen screenshots do not work with custom keyboard shortcuts. Although, the interactive one did work, and I'm using that. Let's talk about how I'm using Gradia for taking and sharing screenshots. Here is the thing, not all screenshots are worth saving. If my intention is to share an interesting piece of information in pictorial format, I might not need that screenshot after it is shared. I mean, you don't want your screenshot folder to look like this, do you? I use Gradia to take a screenshot. And then when I'm done editing the screenshot, I use the copy to clipboard feature and paste it in the required messaging app, forum, or emails. Most of them will accept the image from the clipboard these days, and that's a good thing. Now, once the annotated screenshot is shared, click on the hamburger menu and delete the taken screenshot. In fact, you can make it automatically delete the screenshots taken from within Gradia when you exit the application. We saw that feature in the preferences. This is such a big relief as now only the screenshots that I manually save will be stored on the disk. More control on the screenshots as well as disk space. Gradia is almost perfect. Almost because nothing is perfect in this world. One tiny but worth mentioning issue I noticed was with the save while closing option. Even when you have saved an image after editing, it will ask you to confirm when you try to close Gradia. If you go and disable the confirm on close option from the preferences, it won't ask you to confirm anymore, even when the edited image was not saved. This is annoying as the expected behavior would be to see a prompt at exit when there is an unsaved file. Don't you agree? Overall, this is a nice modern screenshot tool that is worthy alternative to classic shutter and flameshot. and definitely it is an enhancement over the GNOME screenshot tool. Gradia is available in Flatpak format. Give it a screenshot and share in the comment if it's worth a snap or not. And I'll see you in the next video.